Hi, I'm Dr. Jyoti Patel, and today I'm talking about trauma and the role of human connection in healing. So we humans are social creatures. We like to be seen, felt, heard, acknowledged, loved, included. We crave connection. We want to be part of a group. We want to be part of a tribe. We want to be part of a team or family unit. And early in childhood, secure attachments shape us mentally, physically, and emotionally. But what if early in childhood, you were brought into this world, you were cared for, you related to the people that were supposed to care for you, and they related to you in a negative way, where you felt abandoned, felt neglected, felt rejected? That has been shown to lead to chronic diseases as an adult. There was a large study out of Kaiser Permanente in the 1990s. It was over 7,000 adults. They were given a survey of 10 questions regarding childhood trauma. And the higher you scored, the higher the chances of having chronic disease. The two factors that had the most impact were neglect and abandonment. So why does this happen? Well, early in childhood, whether it was an animal study or a human study, they found that when you experienced detachment from a parent, neglect or abandonment, it caused genetic changes. We call this epigenetics, genetic changes to your code. And it upregulates things like your stress receptors, your glucocorticoid receptors get upregulated. So that child will have a heightened sense of stress all the time. And they may live in fight or flight compared to their peers. Not only does it cause an upregulation and genetic change, but it also changes their brain. So the part of the brain that detects stress and fear, the amygdala, physically gets larger and their sympathetic nervous system becomes stronger. So they are living in fight or flight all the time. There's also mitochondrial changes in their cells. So in each cell, we have these tiny organelles called mitochondria that help us produce energy, but they're also vigilantly looking for danger. And so your cellular danger response also becomes heightened. So it's also in the tissues. Now, the downstream effect of being heightened in fight or flight or having an upregulated sympathetic tone means that this child may experience problems with their gut, which is regulated by the sympathetic parasympathetic system. So they may have problems with digestion and constipation. They may have reflux. They may have gut inflammation, food allergies, leaky gut syndrome. So many things that can go wrong when the bacteria in the colon get affected by this early stress. It also affects their immune system. So they may have more food allergies. They may have more environmental allergies. They may have autoimmune diseases. So many things can get downstream affected. And over time, as this child becomes an adult, they may find that they have problems with hormonal regulations, whether it's insulin glucose reactions, whether it's female and male hormone production, whether it's the adrenals and stress hormone reactions. You may have problems with weight metabolic changes. You may have problems with cardiovascular inflammation and heart disease, development of diseases such as diabetes even, and even cancer. So we know that relational trauma, this lack of early connection, feeling loved by the people that cared for us, can cause a downstream effect of chronic disease. But even our life experiences throughout, whether it's divorce, whether it's broken relationships, whether it's grieving and losing someone, all of these things, these loss of human connection, can cause a cascade effect that can affect our health. So there are three major ways that I would recommend you work on reversing some of this effects of loss of communication with people and connection with people. So mind, body, spirit. I'm gonna start with spirit. So your spiritual connection with yourself is really important. Finding love for yourself, looking at that younger self of yours, that maybe infant or 3 or 5 year old that suffered from separation, abandonment, neglect, or abuse, and letting that 5-year-old know that she is loved, that she is special, and she is connected to you. So finding places of self-love is the first place to send the signal of safety, comfort, and love to yourself. Second is connect with people around you. You don't have to have hundreds of friends, but maybe 1 or 2 meaningful connections. Taking the time to reach out to people that you know might need that, or if you're the person that needs it, making an active effort to make social connections, joining groups, joining workout places, joining religious organizations, finding ways to connect with other people, maybe reaching back to relationships that you already have in your life and making them stronger, finding ways to connect with people and being included in their tribe, or making a tribe of your own and including others can help you overcome this relational trauma. Second is mental. The fight or flight neural systems, the sympathetic, parasympathetic system, regulates our stress, fight or flight, or our rest and digest. If you find yourself developing behaviors, coping behaviors, whether it's the perfectionist attitude, always trying to be perfect to get love, whether it's the nurturing personality that you have, trying to help others before you help yourself because you did not receive unconditional love, and this is the way you can receive love, or you find yourself overachieving, you find yourself receiving lots of successes because you feel that other people seeing your successes means that you will be loved more, or you live in fear, you're fearful of death, you're fearful of illness, you're fearful of loss, and that keeps you tethered to that emotional state, those are all coping behaviors, and acknowledging that and making a shift mentally to find new coping behaviors to upregulate your vagal tone. That's your parasympathetic pathways. And some of the ways that I recommend doing that is breath work, yoga, meditation, tai chi, music, going for long drives, finding a hobby, connecting with people, being outside in nature, spending time with your pet, coloring, poetry, writing, anything that brings your brain pleasure, that is not harmful, that's not maladaptive, can actually reprogram the nervous system so that you can shut down the fight or flight and upregulate the rest and digest. So your gastrointestinal system starts to rebalance, your gut microbiome starts to become healthy, your mitochondria go back to making energy for you, your immune system goes back up online, your brain starts shifting. And we've actually seen that with practices such as meditation, we can show functional MRI changes to the brain so that we are making a shift away from fight or flight to rest and digest, from the sympathetic tone to the parasympathetic tone, and we can find balance. The last thing is the physical. A lot of times what we experience are symptoms. We're tired, we're moody, we're hungry, we're craving. We have all these symptoms, we have gastrointestinal symptoms. These physical symptoms also need to be addressed. And I recommend doing that through nutrition, through exercise, through sleep hygiene, through stress-reducing practices, through finding passion and purpose, by reaching out and helping other humans. Those kinds of activities can actually help you heal from that relational trauma that you may have suffered long ago. So remember that our trauma stories tell us who we are. It also tells us about the behaviors that we have generated from those stories and how we have learned to survive and cope. And if you feel like you need to change that, you want to actually change your physical body, I want to give you hope. I believe, and science shows, that you can actually change the chemistry in your body, not just for yourself, but for the generations to come. And the people around you right now, maybe your children or grandchildren, are being impacted by your behaviors. And you can actually change and shift their genetics and their coping behaviors by modeling better ones. So thank you for listening. I'm Dr. Jyoti Patel. Follow me on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Till next time.